Hi, welcome to Nursimandra Academy online crash course for nurses. Today we are going to discuss regarding respiratory disorders in children. Part 9, respiratory disorders in children. First we are going to discuss regarding upper respiratory tract infection, epiglottitis, common cold and sinusitis. This is the epiglottis structure. So any infection to the epiglottis, that is we are calling epiglottitis. It is caused by Haemophilus influenza type B or Streptococcus pneumoniae. Most frequently seen in children with a age group of 2 to 5 years. It is considered as an emergency situation. Now it is very uncommon because HIBU vaccine is included in the routine childhood immunization schedule. So in this, you can see here, this is the epiglottis, and there is any inflammation causing this area, it is known as epiglottitis. Causes of epiglottitis: pediatric population aged 2 to 5 years tend to struggle with epiglottitis more than the adults. Spread by the droplets which harbor infectious agents like bacteria, Streptococcus pneumonia, Haemophilus influenza and all. We have to provide a HIBU vaccine. Should be administered in 3 to 4 doses depending on the brand used. It is administered 2, 4, 6 and 12 to 15 months. Other organism is Streptococcus pneumonia also can cause this epiglottitis. Signs and symptoms for epiglottitis is there will be abnormal position, tripod position will be there. And dysphagia leads to drooling, difficulty of speaking, then apprehension, increased temperature, rapid onset, nasal flaring, using accessory muscles, chest retractions, inspiratory stridors, enlarged epiglottitis elongated on the x-ray or visible. Then cyanosis will be there, drooling of the saliva, tachycardia, tachypnea, sore throat, everything will be there in this epiglottitis. So diagnostic test mainly blood culture or throat culture, CBC, neck x-ray and all doing. Management, the child is treated in ICU with moist and oxygen, humidified oxygen, endotracheal intubation if it is required, antibiotics to treat the infections, then anti-inflammatory medications like corticosteroid to reduce the throat swelling, intravenous fluids and all. We have to provide nursing intervention. We have to maintain a patent airway, then assess the respiratory status and the breath sounds, assess the temperature by the axillary route, not the oral route. To prevent the spasm of the epiglottis and the airway occlusion, no attempt should be made to visualize the posterior pharynx or take an oral temperature. Then prepare the child for a neck x-ray to confirm diagnosis. Administer IV fluid, maintain NPO status, do not leave the child unattended, then do not force the child to lie on, administer antibiotics as prescribed, administer analgesics and antipyretics as prescribed, then administer steroids and humidified oxygen as prescribed, have resuscitation equipment readily available and be prepared for endotracheal intubation if needed. So the nurse should assess for the oxygen status and maintain the airway, assess for the respiratory effort and the rate, breath sounds, respiratory stridor is there, inspiratory stridor you have to check, and the color, whether it is cyanotic, lips blue and all, you have to check, heart rate increased, then chest retractions are there or not, nasal flaring, agitation, keep emergency equipment at the bedside, then monitor for the temperature. Temperature, other routes we have to take other than the oral routes. Always keep the child calm. So when the child cries or become very anxious, this increases the chance of an airway obstruction. So keep the child with the parent and on the lap during treatment if possible. Don't restrain the child. Never leave the child alone. Then provide a calm environment. Then prevent doing things that make the child cry. Allow the child to be in a comfortable position that allows them to breathe. Then keep the child nothing by mouth. Then medication as per doctor, IV fluids, antibiotics, antipyretics, corticosteroids. Prevention by HIBU vaccination. Next condition is the common cold. It is a very common condition in children. may develop at least 6 to 10 colds a year. A cold is caused by a virus. Common one being the virus is the rhinovirus. But others include coronavirus, para-influenza, adenovirus, respiratory syncytial virus and all. Mode of transmission is through air and direct contact. What are the signs and symptoms? There will be running nose, swelling of the lining of the nose, sneezing, cough, headache will be there. Management means the goal of the treatment is to reduce the discomfort caused by the symptoms. Increase the fluid intake. Saline nose drops may be used. Use a bulb syringe to help remove the infant's mucus. Advise adequate rest. This is related to the common cold. Next condition is sinusitis. Sinuses are moist air spaces within the bones of the face around the nose. When sinuses swell or become irritated, the infection is called sinusitis. We can see different sinuses, frontal sinuses, ethmoid sinuses, sphenoid sinuses, maxillary sinuses and all. What are the causes for sinusitis? Causes for sinusitis means when the child has cold or any allergies, the nasal passage becomes swollen and it produces more mucus and the drainage system of the sinus gets blocked. Mucus can be trapped in the sinus leading to growth of bacteria, virus or fungi, which in turn causes sinusitis. What are the symptoms of sinusitis? Means stuffy or runny nose, irritability, mild fever, ear pain, tenderness over the face. These are the signs and symptoms. Then management means sinusitis can be managed with antipyretics, nasal decongestants and antibiotics. Consult the physician whenever the child has a cold that lasts more than 10 days without improvement, a cold that seems to be getting worse after 7 days of the symptom, symptoms of allergies that don't clear with the usual allergy medications. Nursing interventions means we have to assess the child for signs and symptoms of sinusitis, normal saline, nasal drops or a spray and adequate oral fluid intake should be advised. Instruct the patient to give a full course of antibiotics as prescribed. This is the management for the sinusitis. I hope you understood regarding today's conditions. Thank you.